White Album, where you going? As they run him down through the mid lane, get the silence.
Quincy
they're dead
Cruz.
With no buyback.
Unbelievable
as they got their eyes set for these tier four towers.
The emotions, they're just staring at each other. They're not sure what to do. The call's been made. They're running for the tier four.
Look at Yawar. He's ready. He knows. He's hungry. He wants a way to move on in TI as the tier fours will fall. Aster, how quickly things fall apart. GG.
Easy for Leslau. Unbelievable play on the Nature's Prophet to put the pressure when they're coming to your high ground. He's knocking at the back door, and they didn't know what to do. They panicked, and Quincy Crew pulled an incredible fight to stave off. I mean, that game looked like they were in so much trouble.
Unbelievable, and heartbreak central for Aster. The game, they could feel it. It was right there. The pause happened, they got a kill, and afterwards it all slipped away from them, and Quincy Crew are gonna move on at this TI. Unbelievable, unbelievable.
I really felt like Aster had it. They played so well that game. It seemed like they were hitting all their marks and they had a plan of where to go. They're getting the right items, they're pushing the right towers, getting the Aegis, getting the Shard.
Oh.
And to just have that pulled out from under you so quickly, that really is best of ones here in Dota. You can see LOA just pumping up the team right now, keeping them in the booth and having a talk.
And I saw a deep exhale there from Yawar as he exits the booth and obviously going to pay their respects to Team Aster as they will be eliminated from this. But for us now, oh my God, Quinn, what are you doing? We're going to head on back to the panel and break this down.
Oh, I thought this was going to be a very different talk, but oh my goodness. This is Forged in the Fires of NA DPC. He just takes his headset off. You don't need sound. He's just going for it. Did he just take his headset off? He did, right?
He's still playing.
You weren't the only one screaming. We saw Quinn scream quite a bit there, too, on the main stage after that victory. And it is Jake sitting down with Quinn right now.
Hello, hello. Quinn. One of the greatest games I have ever seen. One of the best comebacks in BO1. I'll be real with you. I don't have any questions written down for you. I thought you guys were done. I had 15 Aster questions, buddy. How are you feeling after that?
I feel pretty freaking good. That was a nice win.
I mean, you're more calm, cool, collected than I am. There was a moment, the pause, in the middle. You guys were down. You were looking out. What changed in that moment? How'd you bring it back?
I don't think anything changed, to be honest. I think we were pretty chill, and we knew we had some item timings coming up that we can fight with. Their Aegis is wearing out. Like, I think we were pretty okay. I don't actually think the pause changed that much. We just had some monitor issues, but I think we're pretty okay, actually.
Well, that's good to hear. So, you trusted in the rat. You knew your boy in there with the Nature's Prophet.
He was squeaking around.
He was squeaking. How much was your heart pumping when that Luna was coming at your face? Did you still believe in the rat?
I thought when they were going Thrawn that we were going to win the game right there.
Really? Really?
I mean, we have buys on two cores. It's some, like, 8v5 or something.
So you think they just got a little too close to it?
I mean, they're getting antsy because as Furion is hitting their base, he just squeak, squeak. They can't do anything.
Oh, my goodness. Well, sir, you're done with the BO3s. The BO1s, you're on to the BO3s. America is safe for now. On your back, are you excited to be out of BO1 town?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, we're just taking it one game at a time. I think we already hit our all-time low in the group stage. So, you know, it's only up from here. I think we all feel pretty, you know, carefree and fancy-free. So we're just out there just trying to win one game at a time.
Well, that was truly one game at a time, and it was amazing performance. Thank you so much. And, man, I'm so jazzed for you. Congratulations. Anything out there to say to the Quincy crewers that never gave up, the real members of the crew?
Real OGs? Seems good.
Hell.
Haters? So bad.
Hell yeah. Back to you guys.
All right. Yeah, he definitely felt that one hard. Love to see it. Love to see it. Quincy Crew moving forward here at the International 10. And guys, you've seen this squad perform.